Welcome, welcome. Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining on this Wednesday.
It was Veronica. Well, Megan, sorry.
She's here, too.
Okay. Here, too. Good to see you.
Hello, how are you?
Hey, Tom. Thanks to your patience. Zoom is always a fun thing.
Here you go.
All right, everyone. It looks like there's no one in the waiting room, so let's get going. Caroline, if you want to turn down the music. Hello, we've made it. Welcome, everyone. So good to see all of your faces today. Veronica might go through and mute some of you while we're getting going here, but we'll have time at the end for breakout groups. So you'll get to meet some of your fellow participants. So with that, let's get going and talk about today's agenda. So Caroline, if you could move to the next slide. Today, we are going to introduce some of our staff, talk about norms, expectations, learn more about the San Diego site and the campground where we will be hosted, and a little bit about COVID safety too and how we can keep ourselves safe this summer. So Veronica will be dropping a whole bunch of links in the chat today so we can make this experience really interactive and fun and also informational. We've got a lot to share and a lot to learn today. So we'll be using a parking lot document, which is simply just a Google Doc where we have some Q&A populated. So if you have a question that we aren't answering or aren't getting to, feel free to add it there and someone can answer that question offline. So we maybe have time at the end to get to some of those, but it's a living document that we're adding to for each and every session. So it will transform over the next week. So please, if you've got a question, drop it in the parking lot document. And we'll drop that in the chat a few times. So today is a great way for us to meet each other for the first time or for the many times, some of your familiar faces here today. And so if you're able, keep your camera on because it makes it more fun and engaging for everyone. And yeah, let's go. I'm going to introduce myself and the co-directors here next. So I'm Megan Taylor. I'm the director of Sierra Service Project, and I have worked in the HQ staff for about 12 years and was also a summer staff myself, as well as a youth volunteer. I'm from Portland, Oregon, and I use she, her pronouns. And I'm going to let Caroline introduce themselves.
Hello, my name's Caroline. I use any pronouns. I will be one of the co-site directors in San Diego this summer. And this will be my fifth year on staff, fourth in person. And I was a volunteer for many years before that. I'm originally from the Bay Area, and that's me.
Maggie, you're up.
Hey everyone, I'm Maggie Gagesian. I'm also one of the co-director. So one of the co-directors. This is my sixth year on SSP staff, fourth in person. She, her pronouns, and I grew up in Fresno, California, went to college in Stockton, and I'm currently in the Bay where I just finished seminary.
Congrats, Maggie. You'll hear more from them later on. So next slide. The first thing we're going to do is rename ourselves. So we have a little cheat sheet here. The first thing you're going to put is a number that represents the week that you're attending. So if you're going the first week of July, 3rd through 9th, that's week one. Week two is July 10th through 16th. And week three is July 17th through 13th. So that'll be the first number that you're going to use. And then you'll use what age group you are. So youth, young adult, or adult volunteer, or if you're a family member, you can see those some letters there. And then if you're a staff, board, other person, community member, you're going to use an S. So if you need help renaming yourself, you can ask direct message Veronica. Otherwise, you can go to the triple dots. If you hover over your image and click that to rename, or on your the list of participants, you can find your name go to more and select rename from there. So we have about 20 minutes before we actually get to making breakout groups. So you can ask Veronica for help, but that is one way we are going to divide people into different groups today. All right. So next up, we're going to talk about some norms and expectations. This is a real brief summary of what to expect. And so there's some documents we want you to review offline, and they really outline all of the good stuff. So the main thing is the SSP is committed to creating safe environments for young people and adults and staff, everyone who works together this summer. So we have to treat everyone with respect. And we also want folks to be as engaged as possible in all the activities, whether that's building a wheelchair ramp or serving with one of our community partners, tent camping, all the way through eating meals and singing songs. So a lot of those details can be found in our safe community policy. That's the first link there. The preparation packet, many of you have probably seen that already, has a whole bunch of things, including a packing list, FAQ, other pieces that are really important to know to be prepared for your time in San Diego. And then also we have a whole bunch of documents around COVID-19 safety at SSP. We'll have a video that we're gonna show later today, and that's also on YouTube, a handout that accompanies that, and also a webpage that collects all of these things together. So next up, we're gonna talk about expectations for adult volunteers. So for everyone's safety, everyone 18 and up completes special paperwork through SSP. I know many of you have already been working on that and have done this in years past too. Every year we update our processes a little bit. So thanks everyone for your patience with some of these changes. So everyone will complete a background screening if you're over 18, and this year complete mandated reporter training. There's a new law in California, so we wanna make sure we're doing the best that we can to follow that. Another important rule at SSP is the rule of threes. So one youth and one adult we're gonna avoid. So two and one is good in any combination, meets our safety requirements. And SSP values youth development, but of course, all of our service experiences are for the development and growth of adults too. So we encourage everyone to be open to growing and learning themselves and helping provide opportunities for youth to learn and grow as well. And there'll be a question on this later today, but you do not need to know any hard skills before participating. You don't need to know how to build a ramp, although it's helpful, or anything like that, working in the kitchen, et cetera. Our staff are there to guide and work with your groups this summer. So stay tuned for more on that. Next slide, I'm gonna pass it over to Maggie Gagazian.
All right, we're back. It's time to introduce our program theme for summer 2022 is In This Place. Yes, after 2 years of being in very proximal conditions, conditions of building community far away, we wanted to focus in our program of spiritual reflection, personal introspection, and interpersonal relationship building on the fact that we get to be physically together. There's not a struggle to find community, even though we are all boxes on screens. The irony of me introducing this here is not lost on me. Let's just keep rolling with it. So y'all can read what's on the slide, but the real quick thing to say about the focus on this theme is basically just like everything that place is, the context of where you are, from the smallest, from what will seem like the smallest or most taken for granted things like dirt and rocks and bacteria, to more complex relationships like the ecosystem of animals and plants, to like a whole slew of human relationships, the people who were there before, the first peoples of the land, ancestors of current people on the land, cultures and traditions, and relationships of families. And I'll say from Caroline, Megan, and my site visit to Imperial Beach in Tijuana, I'll emphasize but as our community partners in IB, we're really, really into and emphasizing in this place as a concept. So I'm excited to dive deeper into it, and I hope y'all are too. With that, I'm gonna pass things along to Caroline to go more into the details of our site. Unless, wait a minute, that's Megan. Am I passing it to you, Megan?
It's me. All right, well, San Diego, California, specifically Imperial Beach. Here's a little sneak peek. Here in the middle, you might see me and Maggie at the Binational Garden up against the border wall. Sneak peek into some logos for community partners on the left. Little shot of the estuary we will be by and working with at the bottom there. Bottom right, a previous project. Top right, El Faro, or the lighthouse, which is by the Binational Garden and said border wall. But let's talk about where we'll be staying. So we will be staying at the Tijuana River Valley Regional Park Campground. It's a mouthful, but there's some really great perks to being here. First off, location. It's really close to other places we will be going. So that's ideal. Less driving time means more time together and doing stuff. So we will be tent camping, which isn't new to SSP, but many of us may not have done it with SSP before. So thank you for your grace in this time of transformation. We will be sleeping in cohorts. So the group that you come with, you will tent camp with, just so as to keep cohorted. More details on that, you know, within our COVID safety policies. There are yurts available for rental, but that is up to the individual groups. There are lots of restrooms, single occupancy, and lots of showers. SSP will provide one shower token per volunteer per day, which is about 4 minutes, so those can be used as folks see fit, right? And also a really cool perk about camping here is that there are fire pits, and so we'll provide one bundle of wood, of firewood, for one of the later in the week evenings, so that's something fun and special to look forward to. We will do some meals at the campground and a lot of program. However, we will be utilizing Imperial Beach Neighborhood Center for some dinners and programs as well, and that's also where we will have our tool trailer and lumber yard. We are lucky today to have Pastor John here, the executive director of Imperial Beach Neighborhood Center, who's also a long-term community partner. And Pastor John, do you have anything to share with us?
I'm just excited that you all are going to be here. I think this is going to be the best SSP experience ever, being able to camp out at the estuary and, of course, coming to the Neighborhood Center. The Neighborhood Center is a former United Methodist Church that has been closed and reopened as the Neighborhood Center, which operates as a community connector. So we are about connecting the community together. So SSP fits well within our wheelhouse of connecting SSP into the community. So we're just excited that you're going to be here and look forward to seeing you all this summer.
Thanks, John. Take it away, Maggie.
I have to be unmuted to be heard. Very important. All right. Thank you, Caroline. I'm now going to just quickly introduce some of our community partner work. So you can see in the sort of italicized print at the bottom of the slide, half of our work is with homeowners, the other half will be with community organizations. Our service learning focus with these community partners will include issues around immigration and migrant communities especially with our partners in Tijuana, issues of wealth inequality, which are pervasive in South County, especially Imperial Beach and many communities like it. And of course, issues environmental equality and conservation, which is relevant to a number of our community partners. You'll be seeing a number of them. There's quite a few names there, quite a few acronyms, and they do wonderful work with communities of Imperial Beach, with the biosphere of the Tijuana River Valley watershed, and in the city of Tijuana. In fact, one of the contacts of our partner organizations is here with us. Pastor Guillermo Navarrete is here, who directs a number of migrant shelters and is part of Via Internacional in between San Diego and Tijuana. And Guillermo, I don't know if there's anything you'd like to say to the folks who are here, even if it's just a quick hello. We're so grateful to work with you.
Yeah, thank you for inviting me. Every time since, I think, 5 years working with SSP was a delight, blessing, working with you. Receive my hugs and blessing that you will succeed in this summer. And I will be waiting for you. Another mention is that, I don't know, I have a new title. My title is Party Priest. So you can expect a lot of things in Tijuana.
Thank you so much, Guillermo.
Right on. A little deeper look into some of the community-oriented projects we'll be able to do. On Mondays, the full group has the opportunity to work with the Tijuana River Valley Regional Park, which is where we're staying. So that should be fun, getting some hands-on learning right where we're at in this place. And 15 to 20 volunteers, so not the full group, but could have the opportunity to help at the Tijuana Estuary, I'm not going to say the full name, on Fridays, right? Those who go across to the Tijuana side on Wednesdays will have the opportunity to work at the Binational Garden, et cetera, right? So not every person will have the opportunity to do every project, just like with, you know, the individual home projects. Not everyone will get to do every community project, but there's lots of exciting things to look forward to that we will have opportunities for.
Right. Well, I'd like to quickly go over some info for preparing for your trip and for expectations of the site. So one, it's, of course, there are a whole host of medical and COVID safety expectations that are part of trip prep that you will see in upcoming slides. But also, each site has a packing list specific to it. It's important to, especially stress, well, I mean, for all volunteers of every age, to look at it very thoroughly, and also just to consider the limitations of immediate space that camping and tents will have might have, and just all the things that are going to be logistically different than sleeping in a church or community center. Of course, cannot forget, if you are going to be if you're planning on going to the Tijuana side for Wednesdays, work with community partners and service learning, you will need a U.S. passport. This is very important. Being stoked to work with folks in Tijuana is not enough to cross an international border. If it was, I wouldn't have just spent some of our context there at the site visit. And of course, camping requires a different set of preparations than other trips. Some of that might be cost or space intensive, and those are things definitely worth following up with our wonderful SSP order staff if there might be any issues around it. Good question, Alex from week three. You do not need a passport if you have no plans to cross over into Tijuana and work with organizations there. If you'll just be staying on the US side, you're fine without. And just some things at site, the weather, it's relatively arid, even as we're close to an estuary. You're not in the desert, but it'll get pretty hot just by virtue of having that sun exposure. It's important to prepare for that. It's also good to just know that an estuary is a wetland environment. There will be bugs. It is good to prepare for bugs. And yes, the campground is about a mile from the Pacific Ocean. It is a marvel what the ocean does to your to the climate experience of a particular area. But wherever you are, hydration is important. Water bottles and other things are very recommended for that purpose. And of course, if you can't tell by some of the pictures, good times will be had. That I'm pass this along to, or perhaps is me announcing a stretch break. As we go into the stretch break, you may notice this picture from week two of San Diego's 2019 program. This is the United States side of our Wednesday program with some volunteers, I believe from Santa Clarita United Methodist Church, right there at Friendship Park, about a very strong-armed, well-aimed stone's throw from the campground where you will be staying. With that, let's get some stretches going on.
While we're stretching, because we've been sitting at Zoom for too long today, or maybe our school chairs or desks at work, I want to answer the question in the chat. So someone asked if your whole team has to go to Tijuana or stay in the United States. And no, we're going to be breaking cohorts for this day, and we'll wear masks in cars and any other enclosed spaces. And so it is okay for groups to be split in what they choose to do. Often some folks, have a passport and want to do that, and other folks have other plans. So totally fine to split for that day. Great question. And as we're stretching still, don't forget to keep stretching, everyone. I'm not gonna be the only one stretching. I will let Veronica answer this great question, Lauren, that you have, because I think she's the magic matchmaker and can help you out. So thanks for asking that question about an extra space. So with that,
Go ahead.
It looks like we're done stretching from what I can tell. So I guess we're gonna roll right in to a video. So next up, we're going to talk about the Medical Advisory Council that we've been working with this entire past year to make our plans for the summer. So as you know, we didn't host in-person programs for the past two summers, and we're so excited to be back, and we want to do it safely. So we've got Sophia here with us today. I want to let her introduce herself really quickly. I'll turn it over for you for a minute. I think she's still here.
Hey, sorry.
Hi, Sophia.
Find the unmute. Hi, everyone. My name is Sophia. I am a PA, physician assistant. I was on summer staff in Chiloquin. I also built the ramp that's in front of the parsonage. And I'm really happy to provide y'all with some good COVID guidance. We have a committee of multidisciplinary medical providers, and we've had lots of great meetings to come up with the video you're about to see.
Thanks, Sophia. So Caroline, I think, is gonna tee up our video. It's about 7.5 minutes long. Thanks everyone for your patience. We will link to this afterwards too, so you can share it with folks that aren't here. And then we're gonna have about 3 to 5 minutes for Q&A with Sophia. So if you have questions during the video, just write them down and put them in the parking lot and we'll get to them with her. Thanks.
Hello. In this video, we'll talk about some things we've learned about COVID-19 and how to keep every member of the SSP community safe as we return to overnight programs. These safety plans were developed by SSP's Medical Advisory Council, five healthcare professionals familiar with SSP's programs. Each safety measure is an act of service to our partner communities. Thank you.
Hello all, my name is Katie Strong. I attended SSP as a youth for 5 summers as a volunteer and also served on staff and maybe met some of you during the years of 2017, 2018, and 2019.
Hi, my name is Kelly Schreiber. I'm a board member with SSP.
Hi everyone, my name is Sophia Lariva. I was on summer staff in Chilliwin.
Hello, I'm Dave Herbert. I'm a physician specializing in infectious diseases. And I've been helping SSP develop ways to keep our volunteers, staff, and community safe in this time of COVID.
Here's a brief overview of what we will cover in this video. Vaccination, testing, and quality masking, being outside and volunteer cohorts, hygiene, as well as our response plan to positive cases. We'll talk about all of these things in more detail, but thank you for joining us.
I know that most of us feel that we're just done with COVID, but it is clear that COVID is not done with us, as infections are once again increasing. One of the most important ways we can protect one another from COVID-19 is through vaccination. While we know that vaccination does not completely prevent COVID, it markedly decreases the risk of getting infected, as well as the risk of passing along an infection if you are infected. And of course, it dramatically reduces the chance of serious illness if you do become infected. Since the SSP program inherently includes communal living and interaction among people from many different regions, it is important for us to add as many layers of protection as possible to prevent the spread of this virus. And vaccines are our first line of defense. This especially protects SSP's partner communities, which are historically medically underserved and therefore at higher risk if an outbreak occurs. So to make the SSP service trip as safe as possible, we require full vaccination, including boosters as eligible for everyone. This means being fully vaccinated with 2 doses of the Moderna or Pfizer vaccines, or 1 dose of the Johnson & Johnson vaccination,
plus boosters as eligible.
Since our program is voluntary, we are unable to consider any exceptions since they would place people at increased risk. Thank you and have a great trip.
This summer, we're going to mask up anytime we're in enclosed indoor spaces with people who aren't in our cohort. That means places like kitchens, shared bathrooms, and any indoor community spaces are all going to be masked areas. We also know that really wearing high quality masks makes a big difference. Those are masks like an N95, or like a KN94-95 mask. These have extra layers and filters that really help stop the spread of coronavirus and help protect us and the community that we're serving. We also know that if you have a mask, that's not enough. You gotta wear it the right way. So we're also gonna make sure everyone is covering their nose fully and has a really good seal with their mask around their face. Masks are not going to be required when you're in outdoor spaces where you can maintain physical distance with other people, or when spending time indoors with only your cohort. So that's in spaces like wherever you're sleeping and your vehicles. SSP is going to provide 2 masks for every volunteer for every day as needed. But if you have a favorite brand of mask that you want to bring with you, you're welcome to do so, so long as it's as good or better than the N95s or KN95s that SSP is requiring.
Another way we can prevent the spread of the virus is thorough testing. This is why we require all volunteers to provide a proof of a negative COVID test upon arrival. Both rapid at-home testing and PCR lab testing work. Be mindful of your exposure between testing and arrival. If you feel sick, please stay home, even if you have a negative test. When you arrive, the first thing staff will do is verify each person's negative results with the group leader. Staff will also test everyone 48 hours after arrival and as needed throughout the week. SSP will provide and coordinate all midweek testing, so don't worry about bringing tests with you.
This year, we'll do everything outside as much as possible. All home repair projects will be outdoors to protect the safety of residents and volunteers. We will also eat meals, sing, and do evening program outdoors. See our packing list to make sure you're bringing the right gear and clothes for the weather. Volunteers also have the option to tent camp outdoors at any SSP site.
Cohorting is an important precaution to decrease the impact on the broader community in the event of a positive case. Cohorting will mean that volunteers will stay in their same arrival group, vehicle, work team, and sleeping space. Cabins, tents, and dorm rooms will be shared by cohort. These will have improved ventilation. We will also cohort when eating, when distancing is not possible, and stagger shower times by cohort. In the event someone tests positive, it will be unlikely that they will have spread the virus to other cohorts. Now, we understand this is an adjustment to how we normally mix groups at SSP, so we thank you for your flexibility.
Of course, being safety conscious also means having good hygiene. SSP settings may be rustic, but we have tools to help volunteers and staff do this well. SSP is increasing the availability of hand sanitizer and hand washing stations and uses gloves when serving food. We will also continue our practices of using soapy water to clean, followed by a bleach solution to sanitize the surfaces. Opportunities to serve, which cohorts rotate through, involving daily cleaning and sanitization of the kitchen, tables, restrooms, and high-touch surfaces.
We know that in spite of our best efforts, there is always the possibility of a positive COVID case at SSP programs. In the event someone becomes symptomatic or tests positive, that person will isolate, and others who meet high-risk exposure criteria will also be tested and increase mask usage within their cohort to prevent additional spread. Those who test positive have two options: one, isolating on site for the duration of the week, or two, departing from site to travel home. Especially for those with symptoms, SSP does encourage departure from site. If you test positive within 48 hours of departing SSP site, please notify us so that we can identify other potentially exposed volunteers. All this to say, you have your support from this Medical Advisory Council, and all of these measures have been developed with the intention of decreasing risk to keep everyone safe.
Now that we've gone over SSP's safety plan, we hope you feel more prepared to serve with us. You can read more details in SSP's written materials and can always reach out directly with any questions. The Medical Advisory Council will also make themselves available as we navigate a new way of being together in person. Thank you for prioritizing safety. We can't wait to serve with you.
Thanks, Caroline, for sharing that.
In this video, we'll talk.
And thank you to the Medical Advisory Council for preparing that. So now we have about 5 minutes to ask Sophia questions. So if you feel comfortable, you could speak out loud, you could put it in the parking lot, or write it in the chat. Either way is great. And she's here to help guide us. And so please feel free to raise your hand or unmute. While we're waiting for questions to come in, I do want to note that this is a big adjustment from how we've normally gathered at SSP. So it's normal to be, you know, have some feelings about the ways that we're going to be gathering this year, and that's okay. So just I hope that we all can figure out how to work flexibly and find ways to gather safely this summer. So thanks everyone for your understanding. And you know, this is our plan for this year and not necessarily for all years in the future. So great question, Dawn. Sophia, Dawn is asking, what would you like for verification of testing prior to arrival? Do you want to answer that?
Sure, yeah. So since we're allowing both at-home and lab testing, either a copy of the lab test with your negative result, like an email, would also be fine on your phone. And since if you're doing an at-home test, we do ask that you take a photo of the negative results with some type of like timestamp on, like also in the photo, either like on your computer, or if you use an iPhone, there's a little eye icon, and it shows the time, just so we can confirm the time and the date of your test. Hopefully that answered your question.
Veronica dropped a link to a handout we prepared that accompanies this all and written information. And we have a photo of actually one of our youth board members who took a really nice photo with her phone next to it, and it captures all that we need. So great example in that, take a look. Something else that is new is we're trying to encourage folks to test as close to departure as possible. So while up to 3 days before departure is fine and sufficient, we all know that you can get exposed after you test. So as close to departure as possible is our new best practice. Any other questions? Oh, there's another one from Tom about, will different church cohort groups be allowed to mingle during free time or evening program? Sophia, did you want to answer that?
Sure, yeah, definitely allowed to mingle. We know with COVID that the safest way to all hang out together is outside and distanced. And so when those two check boxes are checked, then those are wonderful opportunities for folks to mingle and still have some of that SSP experience.
Great question, Tom. That's why we've made all of our site arrangements the way that we have this year. So in San Diego, camping outside is also a huge difference from how it's been in the past, but that basically enables us to do everything a little bit easier than we would have in a big group setting. So perks of having bathrooms and showers on site that are single occupancy, and you're staying in your cohorts for, you know, sleeping. But other than that, we're all at the campground together. So yay. Great question. Will song time still be happening? Sophia, I'll let you answer that too, because it's more fun that way.
To be honest, I don't know the answer to this, but I'm going to say yeah, because it's outside and we can socially distance. So yes.
Check those boxes. So yes. Great job. Yes, the answer is yes. So we might have some adjustments for, we like to get really close in some of our dances, et cetera, but we can alter it this year for a little more social distancing outside while singing. Great. One more question two more questions. So Wendy asked, in addition to Tom's question, one of the main positives for your youth is building community. How can we do so outside of our cohort groups? So I'll answer this one if that's okay. We're hoping to mix groups during evening program into kind of maybe small group teams, or call them something else other than work team or cohort. So since we'll be outside and don't have to travel anywhere, most cases it's, we're trying to find ways we can mingle as much as possible. So yes, great question. So many questions. Okay, we have two activities more to do. So I'm gonna transfer these questions over to our parking lot and answer them there. And I'm gonna turn it over to Veronica, who's going to use some breakout groups to actually get to talk to some people that's attending in your week. So thanks everyone for all the questions. Keep adding them and we'll address them in a written format.
Thank you. All right. Would one of our site directors kind of share more about the questions while I'm getting ready to send you to your breakout rooms?
Yeah. So Veronica's going to put us in various breakout rooms according to those names that we put in. Thank you for doing that, by the way. And we'll talk about these things. If you want to maybe snap a picture of the screen, I'm not sure you'll be able to see it once you go into the breakout rooms. So yeah, if you want to do that, you'll have that accessible. So just introduce yourself. If you feel comfortable, share your pronouns. And then where you're from, talk about SSP experience. And then we just have some fun get to know you questions in here, including what is your favorite place in the world? Is that theme connected? I don't know. And question two, something you're excited for this summer, and it could be SSP or other. You're welcome. I just read the slide. But don't feel limited to just the things that are on this slide. You know, if the conversation goes. Have a good chat.
All right, you'll be in your rooms for about 6 minutes, so make sure it's speedy and popcorn to folks so that everyone can share and message me with any questions. The questions are also in the chat for you to reference. So go to your rooms.
Well, awesome. Sorry, let's see. This, I'm gonna share for a brief moment to show you this screen. What? A Kahoot quiz. Maggie, are you gonna? It's Maggie.
Veronica will share. I will be emceeing.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Okay, give me just a minute to pull that up. And Maggie, if you could kind of talk about the Kahoot.
All right. So, if you've never been in cahoots before, I recommend it. Just, you know, get together with some of your friends or casual acquaintances and stir up some variety of ruckus. Different spelling. A Kahoot with a K and an exclamation point. That is like a website-based quiz that in this case is gonna be about some of the stuff we discussed at this orientation specific to SSP San Diego, or in general to what SSP 2022 is going to be like.
If you've never joined a Kahoot before, you can use either the computer that you're on or another device. You can use this QR code to join and the PIN number there.
Veronica, we are seeing the Kahoot library currently and not the...
Oh no, that's the wrong screen. Okay, just gonna... Here we go. Y'all can see the right screen now.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. Dang it. All right. With that, I think we are ready to get going. So good luck, everybody. All right. So question one. What norms does SSP expect from all its volunteers? Red, only be nice to people from your church. Blue, treat all members of the SSP community with respect. Green, talk over SSP staff when giving instructions. Or yellow, do your best to be an engaged participant in all aspects of SSP activities. Say, all right. Well, our correct answers were blue and yellow. Treat every member of this community we're building together with respect and do your best to be an engaged participant in all aspects of SSP activities. True or false? I need to know how to use tools before coming to SSP. Is this true or is it false? Perhaps we can go to our person on the roof hammering some boards in for some commentary. Oh my goodness. In fact, you do not need to know anything about tools before coming to SSP. For those who said you did, it's okay. It's a common assumption. But that's what folks like our construction team coordinator team are for, to give you some for home repair projects, give you the know-how on how to safely use a variety of tools. And sometimes those tools aren't literally going to be circ saws and hammers. They're going to be skills for removing invasive plant life, or skills of cross-cultural humility as you encounter communities you've never been a part of before, or even how to safely handle raw chicken, the most dangerous power tool of them all, raw poultry. All right. Let's look at the scores. Congratulations, everyone whose name was on screen. What can you find in the prep pack? We've got options here, folks. It's a big prep packet. I know. We went through it. Packing lists, FAQ, COVID-19 safety, typical daily and weekly schedules. This is all good stuff. I mean, how do you choose? All right. Yeah, it's the whole thing. I told you, it's a big prep packet, and we have all four colors of our RGBY rainbow here. That's right. Prep packet is detailed. Ooh, got some change in the standings. Hey, I like this one. What is SSP's summer 2022 theme? Man, I see some good theme candidates here. Arise, a place at the table, love courageously in this place. I mean, at least one of those sounds like a theme that could be this year. In this place. Yes, that is this summer's theme. About the full placeness of this place. Those other three previous year's themes. I'm just gonna say, I'm out here advocating for Build Together 2. Still isn't happening yet. All right, changing the statistics. Now on to question 5. Who are SSP's partner communities this summer? Man, I'll tell you, one of these is an answer I wish were true. which one of these places that one could be in will SSP be a part of? Yeah, that is right. Whoever clicked Spokane, you're reading my mind. I too wish we were gonna be there as well. But we will be focusing in on work with three partner communities, Smith River up in Del Norte County, San Diego, specifically Imperial Beach, and to a certain extent, Tijuana, and the binational community made between San Diego and Tijuana. And of course, Saley out there on the Navajo Nation. Scores keep on changing. All right. Love a dynamic cahoot. Question 6, what should you pack for the work site? All right, gloves, ooh, profane t-shirts, closed-toed shoes, or crop tops. And so many great options. But unfortunately, only two of them are applicable for a work site. That's right, I would not recommend a crop top or a profane t-shirt unless, of course, you are putting some chicken wire over some crops to avoid them being assailed by some birds. I guess not chicken wire, some netting. You know what I mean. Anyway, bring your gloves, bring your closed-toed shoes. Very important. Question 7. Where will we be staying in San Diego? All right, look at those answers rolling in. Could it be downtown, in a public school, a local church, or camping at a regional park? I hope it's, say, that's right, it's camping at a regional park. Oh man, and I for one am really stoked for it. It's not new, but it's different. And it's a pretty cool park too. Hey, question 8. Which of the following are community partners of SSP San Diego? If you were there, it's a big list. We got so many partners. which is, I think, maybe the most exciting thing about this year's program in San Diego, South County. Both our IB partners, our ecological partners, and our Tijuana partners. Yeah, that is right. Four of them. We got so many community partners. And there's even more than the ones you see here. That's so exciting. I know, like, I'm kind of supposed to say that as one of the site directors, but I'm genuinely stoked. Question 9 about medical safety. When should you take your first COVID test for SSP? We have, let's see. Right, yes. The answer is number one, as close to leaving as possible. No more than 3 days in advance. 3 days in advance. And if you weren't here for the Medical Advisory Council video portion of this orientation, it is available on the World Wide Web, those three W's in the URL. You can find it there. Question 10, getting so close. When do you wear your mask at SSP? Ooh. Maybe, yes, all right. For those who selected, when interacting with community members and indoor activities, except sleeping, eating, and personal hygiene, you are correct. Note that on the construction site isn't a bad idea. There are some times when you'll want to be wearing a mask to avoid inhaling materials such as sawdust or other particulate debris. And when interacting with my cohort, that one, even though cohort is an intimate setting, those are the folks you're traveling with and going to be sharing the same germ pool with, and therefore the folks you are good to be unmasked around. Right. As we run very close to the end of our time together, I'd like to thank you all for coming as we finish this quiz as well. So why do we wear masks at SSP? And hey, I believe that is Smith River staffer Ashley Rios, designer of our In This Place t-shirt and stickers. Why do we wear masks at SSP? We can't ask Ashley, but they're demonstrating it. And for folks who answered, yes, it is to protect our fellow volunteers and our community partners. It is not to hide your face or make it harder to breathe. We're all stoked about each other's faces and we love breathing here. All right, our final question. This summer, I will. Oh man, here we go. What will you do? What would you do if you were San Diego 2022 construction coordinator Ryan Forletta looking across the wall at his folks on the US side? That is a nice spot. One of our premier dog spotters, Ryan Forletta. Right, oh man. And you can see all the answers are correct. I hope you build community and have fun with your peers and learn new skills and all that good jazz. All right, our podium. We got Jacob and Victoria and Kevin. Great job. Numbers 1, 2, and 3 respectively on the board. Number 1 in my heart. That applies to every one of you. Thank you so much for testing your volunteer prep knowledge and for expanding it by way of joining us tonight. Well, I guess this afternoon. It's pretty light out here on the West Coast.
And with that, Caroline, if you could show the very last slide, we want to thank you everyone for being here, spending the time to briefly cover 1 bazillion things. We do have a lot of links to share in the chat and we'll send a follow-up email next week. And if you joined late, there's the video of this whole session will be recorded. You can watch it later on your own time or send it to other folks in your group that weren't able to join. So we're almost done answering all these great questions in the parking lot. So check back later and we'll have those answered. And feel free to stick around if you wanna ask Veronica or I some questions. Otherwise, thank you so much for being here. You can reach the Medical Advisory Council by emailing mac@sierraserviceproject.org if you have any specific COVID safety related questions. Info@ is a great way to reach Veronica and I with all of your general program site specific questions. We'll get those answered. They're often really helpful so that we can remember what we need to add to our website or share along with other folks. So please don't be shy about asking. And you can reach us Monday through Friday, 9 to 6. And thank you so much for being here, everyone. Hope you have a great rest of your spring and see you this summer, just a few weeks away. Thanks so much, everyone. See you this summer.
See you this summer. Thank you for your time. We're so stoked to see you in Imperial Beach.
Bye.
Bye, all.
Thanks for being here. Nice to meet you.
Hey, Pravin, I can answer your question for you if you want. By the way, thanks for being here. So awesome. So glad you're going to San Diego. Hey, everyone. Pravin's been volunteering in the SSP office in the tool library. Very exciting and cool. As you enter your roster information, there's an upload feature for a photo of your COVID card. So it's pretty simple. Does that answer your question? All right, see you later. Hope to see you in the tool library soon. Bye. Yay. Mm-hmm. Thanks for being here,
Oliver, Deb. Do you have any questions? Nope.
Nope.
Bye.
Good to see you, Deb.